Snapdragon 8 Elite, MediaTek Dimensity 9400, or Apple A18 Pro? Which one is the best mobile phone chipset? I am Mo, and I did a similar test before, but this time I applied all the feedback that you gave me to make the test more fair. Most importantly, this time I'm using the OnePlus 13 instead of Xiaomi 15 for the Snapdragon 8 Elite phone to get better results. The Dimensity 9400 phone is Vivo X200 Pro, and for the A18 Pro, I'm using the iPhone 16 Pro Max. In each category, a phone can get from 1 to 3 based on its ranking, and I also excluded AnTuTu and will also consider thermals in the test. For the first test, I will play Genshin Impact on the max setting and 60 frames per second on all three phones. I will measure the temperature of each phone every 5 minutes while playing, and even though I don't have a way to see the frame drops, I'll keep a close eye on it and mention anything weird that happens. I'm playing Genshin Impact because it is written in Unity, the most popular game engine for cross-platform game development. All phones handle the game very well in the first 15 minutes of the game, without any issues and frame drop. They all got warm, and after measuring the temperature with thermometer, they all had similar temperatures. Vivo X200 Pro was the hottest, but only less than a degree or two, and the OnePlus 13 had the lowest temperature, even though it had a larger hot area compared to iPhone 16 Pro Max. By the end of half an hour of testing, the iPhone 16 Pro Max was the only phone that got a bit laggy. There were visible frame drops while playing Genshin Impact on the max setting and 60 frames per second. While the OnePlus 13 and iPhone 16 Pro Max had similar temperatures, the Vivo X200 Pro was 2 degrees hotter than the other two. But they all handled the game extremely well. If you look at the temperature chart, you will notice that OnePlus 13 with a Snapdragon 8 Elite is the coolest phone. The reason the max temperature at the end is similar to the iPhone A18 Pro is most likely due to throttling of the iPhone. For me, the winner is clearly the OnePlus 13. I would rate Dimensity and iPhone the same. Dimensity had a better performance, while A18 Pro had better thermals, and they got 2 points each. For the second test, I'm gonna run Adobe Premiere and export a long video from YouTube in 4K 30 frames per second. Adobe products usually have a very good compatibility with Apple chipsets. It is always difficult to separate the chipset and its raw performance without considering applications, codec, and operating system. They are always a part of it. To my surprise, the iPhone with the A18 Pro finished the task in only 2 minutes, which is crazy fast. The Dimensity finished in 5 minutes and 20 seconds. The OnePlus with the Snapdragon finished in 5 minutes and 51 seconds. The A18 Pro gets 3 points. The Snapdragon gets 1 and the Dimensity gets 2. Sometimes, some applications have better compatibility with certain chipsets and operating systems because of the codecs that they support. I assume that's why Premiere did such a big favor to Apple's silicon chipset. To make the test fair, I also included CapCut this time. I exported the same video with the same setting on all three phones. This time, Dimensity surprised us and finished first in 1 minute and 35 seconds. Snapdragon finished in 1 minute and 41 seconds, a close second. The iPhone and A18 Pro lasted 3 minutes and 47 seconds this time. We got the exact reverse of the last test. Therefore, Dimensity received 3 points, A18 Pro only 1, and Snapdragon gets 2. Now, the match is extremely close. The battery percentage is not that representative, but if you need to know, Vivo is 90%, iPhone is 88%, and OnePlus is 85%. Running these tests and games makes your phone quite hot, and you also run out of battery quickly. However, with the sponsor of today's video, Charge iSmack 2, you don't need to worry. This 10,000 mAh wireless power bank has an RGB cooling fan. When I travel, I use Charger products, especially the original iSmack. And I'm pleased to see that their new iSmack 2 is not only smaller, but also looks much more modern and classy. The power bank is a Qi 2 power bank with an insane charging speed, up to 30 watts wireless charging. I brought it on a recent trip, and I'm pleased to say that the active fan keeps the power bank cool. You won't toast your hand playing games while it's attached to your phone. The active cooling is not a gimmick, and it does actually work and help reduce the temperature on the power bank. And the sound is also not that loud. You can hear it a bit. I actually use it on my Galaxy S24 Ultra all the time. I put the link in the description down below. Thanks for Sharjah for sponsoring this video. For the next test, I exported 120 photos in RAW and JPEG format from Adobe Lightroom. Initially, it seems like Android phones would have the upper hand and be ahead of the game. However, the iPhone with A18 Pro stole the show and finished the task in 6 minutes and 19 seconds. Both Snapdragon and Dimensity finished in 7 minutes. Even though the OnePlus with Snapdragon finished half a second later, we should also consider that I didn't exactly press the start button in the same millisecond, and the race was too close. Also, the thermals of Snapdragon were 2 degrees cooler than those of Dimensity. Therefore, I give Dimensity and Snapdragon 2 points and A18 Pro 3 points. We are done with the real world test, and we are gonna move to benchmarks. I'm gonna run 2 benchmarks, Geekbench and 3DMark. I also excluded AnTuTu based on your feedback because it's not comparable cross-platform. Geekbench runs multiple small burst tasks over a short period, and it pushes the phones to perform various things like edge detection, text recognition, and other simple tasks, included in running applications. In single core performance, Dimensity got the lower score of 2,695, A18 Pro got 3,535, and Snapdragon got 3,160. The more important score is multi-core, since phones and operating systems are improving and utilizing all cores and multitasking. Here, Dimensity 9400 got around 8,200, iPhone got around 8,800, and Snapdragon got around 9,600. I will give 3 points to a Snapdragon, 2 points to A18 Pro, and 1 to Dimensity 9400. Again, the battery percentage is not representative, but if you need to know, right now Vivo has 79%, iPhone has 79%, and OnePlus has 81%. Again, it's not representative, but I know many of you will ask. The next benchmark I'm going to run is 3DMark. 3DMark is a simple benchmark. The wildlife stress test runs a loop 20 times and counts the number of frames the phone ran. The phones use different underlying libraries, but it doesn't matter. The frame rate per second matters most when playing games, and users don't care about the library used for rendering. Observe that the iPhone 16 Pro Max is limited to 60 frames per second throughout running wildlife, while the other phones easily go behind 120 frames per second. I'm not entirely sure why this is the case, and I think the iPhone is limiting the frame per second here for some reason. The test is finished, and the iPhone got a 96% stabilization while not getting hot. Again, it is because the phone didn't run at its full potential here. Vivo's best score was 19K, iPhone was 10K, and OnePlus was 24K. I'm not gonna include this test in the final result since it's not a real application, and it seems there is a limitation on the iPhone about the number of frames per second on the wildlife test. Therefore, Dimensity got 10 points, A18 Pro got 11 points, and Snapdragon 8 Elite got 11 points too. So I know the test was pretty close. Also, if I would have chosen a different set of applications, probably we would have seen a different result as we've seen it in the last test that I've conducted. My conclusion is that in 2024 and 2025, you don't really need to choose a phone based on the chipset. Both of these 3 options are quite powerful. The capacity of the iPhone battery is lower, and because of the conjunction of iOS and also the power management there and also A18 Pro, it uses less power. But at the same time, you can't really say it is because of the chipset, but rather it is probably because of how Apple engineered the whole ecosystem. But anyway, on Android phones, you always get a higher battery capacity, and with the new battery technology, it doesn't also add any bulk or weight to the battery and to the device, so it doesn't matter really at the end. And also temperature wise they are quite close, performance wise they are also super close, so I would go with any of them. The only thing that you may want to consider is whether you want to do emulation, for example, which usually Snapdragons are better at that, or if you want to play some console games, usually iPhone is better, so you should go for A18 Pro. But other than that, I would say they are all very, very similar. If you enjoyed this video, you can also watch the last test that I've done. Last test, I've actually used Xiaomi 15 for Snapdragon, which was not the best choice, but I also included Exynos and also the Pixel G4 Tensor chipset. You can also watch that video next. Thanks for tuning into Tecmo, and I will see you in the next one.